So hi everyone and welcome back once again to the session of PIB 247. In today's session, as usually, I will bring to you some more important questions from the PIB news which are relevant for the ESI section of RBI Grade B and NABARD. And remember guys, this is for the current affair part of ESI. For the static part, you have to do other things also. And NABARD ka exam almost aa chuka hai and some people are asking ki kab tak ke current affair karne chahiye. So in my opinion, you have to cover the current affairs till 10th of September. 17-18 तारीख को एग्जाम है, तो एक हफ्ते पहले तक का करंट अफेयर आपको पता होना चाहिए. तो 10 सितंबर इन माय ओपिनियन आपको 10 सितंबर तक के करंट अफेयर्स करने चाहिए. ऑलराइट, सो लेट्स बिगिन विद द टुडे सेशन. बट बिफोर वी बिगिन, डू सब्सक्राइब टू द चैनल एंड प्रेस दिस बेल आइकन. यू कैन ऑल्सो ज्वाइन दिस टेलीग्राम ग्रुप. हियर यू विल गेट द पीडीएफ ऑफ दिस सेशन. यू कैन ऑल्सो आस्क एनी डाउट हियर एंड इसका लिंक यू विल फाइंड इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन. सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट वेरी फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन. इट सेज, Which of the following companies of Government of India has launched Namasya app to empower MSEs? MSEs here stands for micro and small enterprises. Micro and small enterprises by providing information relevant to MSEs. So this app guys will provide the relevant information to the functioning for the working for the proper working of micro and small enterprises. And this app remember has been launched by NALCO, which is National Aluminium Company Limited, NALCO. All right, and the full form of this app is what? NALCO Micro and Small Enterprise Yoga Yog application. All right, so this is the full form. Do remember the full form also. Namasya stands for NALCO Micro and Small Enterprises Yoga Yog application. This is the full form of Namasya, and of course it has been launched by National Aluminium Company Limited. And this has been launched, as the question says, to provide relevant information to to help the micro and small enterprises of the country. It is a bilingual app, and it also provides a platform to highlight the NALCO's steps. NALCO's जो भी NALCO जो है वो कर रहा है for empowering the MSEs, उसके बारे में भी यह app जानकारी देगा. Right? NALCO's efforts towards development of MSEs in the country. So इसमें हमें इतना ही पढ़ना है. And talking about NALCO. So NALCO was established in the year 1981. It works under the Ministry of Mines. And who is the Minister of Mines? Mr. Prahlad Joshi. And he is also the Minister of Coal and the Minister of Parliamentary Affairs. His Lok Sabha constituency is Dharwad in Karnataka. And talking more about NALCO, so it is headquartered in Bhubaneswar. Bhubaneswar mein iska headquarter hai. And Mr. Patra is the chairperson of NALCO. I'm forgetting the full name of Sridhar Patra. Yes, Sridhar Patra is the chairman of NALCO. All right. So this was about this news, and therefore the correct answer is what? NALCO, option A. NALCO guys is the correct answer to this question. Moving ahead to question number 2, which says, with which of the following payment banks LIC Housing Finance Limited has partnered to offer housing loans to its customer. जो जिस ये जो payment bank है इसके customers को LIC Housing Finance अब home loans देगा, उसके लिए partnership हुई है. Alright, to providing loans to the customer of this payment bank, LIC Housing Finance Limited has partnered with this payment bank. Alright, this is the question, and you have to tell the name of that payment bank which this partnership has been done. So remember, the payment bank here in the question is India Post Payment Bank. India Post Payment Bank and LIC Housing Finance Limited has partnered with each other to provide home loans to the customers of India Post Payment Banks. All right. Now, what will the responsibility of LIC HFL under this MOU? So it will have the responsibility of credit underwriting, processing and disbursement of the loans, while India Post Payment Bank will have the responsibility of sourcing. उनका काम क्या होगा? सोर्स करना. और बाकी जितना भी काम होगा वो किसका होगा? LIC Housing Finance Limited का. Alright. Now talking more about this news. So remember, LIC Housing Finance Limited is providing home loans starting from 6.66% for loans up to rupees 50 lakh. And there is a product of LIC Housing Finance Limited. This is although unrelated to this MOU because ये बिल्कुल अलग product है, but in the PIB it was mentioned, so no one knows ki isme se bhi question aa jaye. So LIC Housing Finance Limited has a home loan product which is known as Grah Varishtha. Do remember the name of this product, Grah Varishtha. The question can come like, which of the following organization, which of the following housing finance company is offering Grah Varishtha home loan product? This is type ka question aa sakta hai. So Grah Varishtha, as the name suggests, it is for retired or serving employees of PSU, insurance, central bank, central government or the state government employees and etc. Okay. And talking about India Post Payment Bank, so it was established in the 2018 established what it is headquartered in New Delhi. And it works under the Department of Post के अंदर ये काम करता है. एंड जे वेंकट रमु इज द एमडी एंड सीईओ. जे वेंकट रमु इज द एमडी एंड सीईओ एंड ही वॉज रिसेंटली अपॉइंटेड. सो नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन. सो द करेक्ट आंसर गाइस टू दिस क्वेश्चन इज इंडिया पोस्ट पेमेंट बैंक, विच इज द ओनली पेमेंट बैंक विच इज गवर्न बाय द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया. गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया के पास एक ही पेमेंट बैंक है जिसका नाम है इंडिया पोस्ट पेमेंट बैंक. ऑलराइट, मूविंग अहेड टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 3. This is regarding the PIDF scheme, Payment Infrastructure Development Fund. Consider the following statements regarding PIDF scheme and you have to identify the correct statement. But the question is, why we are discussing about PIDF? There must be some news regarding that. So yes guys, the news is that the PIDF scheme has now been extended to the street vendors which are being identified under the PM Swanidhi scheme. PM Swanidhi ke under jo street vendors identify hoye hain in tier 1 and tier 2 cities. Remember this. In tier 1 and tier 2 centers or cities, उनके लिए भी PIDF scheme अब extend कर दी गई है. Alright, so the news is that the PIDF scheme has been extended to the street vendors identified under the PM Swanidhi scheme from tier 1 and tier 2 center. And this has been done, of course, to increase the sphere of digital connectivity across the country. Alright, digital transactions को बढ़ावा देने के लिए ऐसा किया गया है. And PIDF scheme, as you all know, it is being implemented by RBI. It came into force in the month of January this year only, 2021, and it has the objective to deploy payment acceptance infrastructure. जो POS machines वगैरह होती है, payment accept करने का जो infrastructure होता है, वो उनका objective है, वो deploy करना at subsidized rate. And this will be done in tier 3 to tier 6 centers. Tier 3 to tier 6 center, but don't get confused. जो news है उसमें यह है कि जो street vendors होंगे PM Swanidhi के under, वो tier 1 और tier 2 centers वाले होंगे. But the scheme's objective, अगर हम बात करें तो वो tier 3 से tier 6 centers तक का है. Alright. So what is the difference? The difference is that in tier 3 to tier 6 centers, there is no criteria of PM Swanidhi. But in tier 1 and tier 2 centers, there is a criteria that this scheme will be extended to only the street vendors of identified street vendors under PM Swanidhi scheme. Alright, so this is the difference. I hope this is clear. And the special focus of this particular scheme is in the northeastern region. And of course, this will be provided at the subsidized rate. Agar government utna hi paisa legi, to of course, to usme government ka kya role raha. Alright, the fund manager, this fund PIDF is being managed by an advisory council which is headed by one of the deputy governors of RBI. Now talking more about this period of operation, so the RBI or the government has the target to implement this particular scheme and in till the completion of 3 years from 1st of January 2021. 1 January 2021 ke baad 3 saal tak isko pura kar dena hai iske targets ko. And the current corpus of this is rupees 345 crores. Now I know the initially announced corpus was 500 crores, 250 crores will be given by RBI and rest 250 crores will be given by the card companies hoti hain wo dengi. But abhi iska jo total corpus hai currently, that is 345 crores, 250 crores from RBI and the rest 95 crores from the authorized card networks. All right. And subsidy, how much? 30% to 50% in the case of digital physical POS, point of sale machines, while 50% to 75% in case of digital POS. All right. So guys, this was about this news and now let's come back to the question. You have to identify the correct statement here. The fund manager of the scheme is the office of the governor of RBI. No, is that so? No, it is a advisory council and headed by the deputy governor of RBI, one of the deputy governors. The current corpus of the fund is 500 crores. The current corpus is not 500 crores. Its total corpus is 500 crores. Current is 345. This is incorrect. A subsidy of 50 to 75% of cost of physical POS is provided. In case of physical POS, it is 30 to 50. While in case of digital POS, it is 50 to 75. So all the statements are absolutely incorrect. Option E will be the correct answer. None is correct. Moving ahead to question number 4. Where has the first Atmanirbhar Bharat corner been inaugurated? So the government of India is focusing too much on the self-reliance. Government of India self-reliance ke upar Atmanirbhar hone ke liye kaafi zyada utsuk hai. And uske liye bahut sare jo initiatives hai government ne launch bhi kiye hain so that the government of India or you can say the people of India will be self-reliant in every sphere of their life. So regarding that, where has this first Atmanirbhar Bharat corner been inaugurated? So remember, this has been done under the celebrations of 75th Independence Day, which is of course Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav. And under this Mahotsav, TRIFED, under these celebrations, TRIFED will establish Atmanirbhar Bharat corner in 75 Indian missions or embassies across the country. Puri duniya mein 75 Indian missions or embassies aise identify kiye jayenge, 75 total, and where this Atmanirbhar Bharat corner will be established. Now what is the meaning of this corner? क्या होगा यहाँ पे इस कॉर्नर में? So basically guys, it will be a space where GI tag tribal art and craft products besides natural and organic products will be showcased. Okay, वहाँ पे उनको दिखाया जाएगा जो GI tagged art and craft है इंडिया का, या फिर organic products हैं, या फिर जो other products हैं जिसमें इंडिया का कल्चर, रिच कल्चर दिखता है, उसका वहां पे शोकेस होगा. उससे पता चलेगा दुनिया को कि यस, नाउ वी आर सेल्फ रिलायंट, नाउ वी आर आत्मनिर्भर. ऑलराइट, द वेरी फर्स्ट आत्मनिर्भर भारत कॉर्नर हैज बीन सक्सेसफुली इनॉग्रेटेड इन बैंकॉक, इन द एम्बेसी इन बैंकॉक, व्हिच ऑफ कोर्स इन थाईलैंड. एंड अमंग द 75 कंट्रीज, सम ऑफ दीज कंट्रीज आइडेंटिफाइड बाय द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया आर दीज. ऑफ कोर्स यू नीड नॉट रिमेंबर ऑल दीज नेम्स. एंड ट्राइफेड विल ऑल्सो बी एस्टैब्लिशिंग एन आत्मनिर्भर कॉर्नर्स in 75 embassies of foreign countries set up in India. यानी इंडिया के एम्बेसी में, बाहर कंट्रीज में जहां पे भी इंडिया की एम्बेसी है, वहां पे भी ये 75 embassies में establish होगा आत्मनिर्भर भारत corner. And also in the foreign embassies which are there in India. Okay. So guys, this was about this news. And now let's come back to the question. So the correct answer guys to this question will be option A, Bangkok, Thailand, where the very first Atmanirbhar Bharat corner has been inaugurated by TRIFED. Now let's come to question number 5, which is the last question, which is, which of the following two ministries have recently organized webinar on Poshan Vatika to alleviate the malnutrition in the country? Malnutrition ko alleviate karne ke liye kahan, kaun si do ministries ne Poshan Vatika organize kiya tha? Very important question for upcoming NABARD exam. Or I hope you all know what is the meaning of Poshan Vatika here. Poshan Vatika means nutrition garden. Nutrition garden. Where they organically grow vegetable and fruits. Basically it is an initiative to, you know, logo ko motivate karne ke liye so that they can organically grow vegetables and fruits, and which will of course lead to the, which will of course alleviate the malnutrition. All right. So let's talk about this news. So the Ministry of Women and Child Development and Ministry of Ayush, Ministry of Women and Child Development and Ministry of Ayush have jointly organized this webinar on Poshan Vatika, and this was of course to alleviate the malnutrition. Objective is very much clear. Talking about Poshan Vatika, so it is, as I told you, also known as nutritional garden, and its objective is to ensure supply of nutrition through organically homegrown vegetables and fruits. All right. Now of course Poshan Vatika, और अभी एक तारीख से सात जो सितंबर है, this is also celebrated or observed as the month of nutrition or the Poshan Maha. And of course talking about mission 2.0, so it was announced in this year's budget 2021-22, and it is of course an integrated effort for enhancing the nutritions of the child and women across the country. And it includes various schemes like National Crèche Scheme, Anganwadi Scheme and other schemes. Alright. So guys, this was about this news, and here the correct answer is Ministry of Women and Child Development and Ministry of Ayush. So option E, 1 and 3 would be the correct answer to this question. And guys, that's it for the session. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Milte hain Monday ke session mein. Goodbye, take care. And God bless.